I want to get into that a little bit more because, I mean, there is some indication that if anyone has momentum and at this particular point in time, it is Jack Layton and the New Democrats. They just put out a new ad last night that goes after Michael Ignatieff. I mean, what's going on there, Robin?
Well, you know, the traditional nightmare for an NDP campaign director is the one Scott framed at the very beginning. It's being shoved by lazy media out of a two-horse race. And fighting your way back into that and into contention is a big challenge. But the parallel challenge is there are a huge number of Canadians who are soft Liberal NDP voters, and they flip back and forth with the tide, leaders, circumstances. And one of the challenges internally for the NDP is if you attack the Liberal brand or if you attack the Liberal leader, are you more likely to make a soft Liberal voter less comfortable about defecting to the NDP? So there's always a huge debate internally. Do you simply attack the Conservatives and say, we're better Conservative attackers than they are, which is the way you saw Jack start off, or do you then go to the next level and say, not only that, they're not any different than the Tories, and you got to vote for us if you want real change. And that's the tension they're playing with.
Given, Jamie, that a disproportionate number of Liberal voters have a second choice as the New Democrats, which makes sense why they're doing this, is there any chance that the New Democrats could catch the Liberals in this campaign? And if they did, does that change everything?
Well, wow, if they did, it would change everything. Yeah. I don't think so. Doesn't feel like that's what's taking place. And I think one of the reasons that Jack is actually focusing in Quebec as well is that the interesting thing about Quebec for all of us who talk about this on television or write about in the newspaper or whatever is everyone's, of course, preoccupied and fascinated with Quebec. So he gets an additional buzz, even though Scott's right to say, go focus on British Columbia. He doesn't actually create the same media buzz that making some progress in Quebec. There's all this mythology about Quebec, right? We don't really understand it. Even those of us who grew up there are not quite sure. And this idea that there's these massive shifts at the last minute and so on. So, you know, it might happen, but wouldn't that be a story if it did?
And it's your Everest. Right, Robin?
Yeah.
I mean, the party.
For sure.
In 1988, I remember a post-campaign kangaroo court I was subjected to, along with the rest of the campaign leadership.
And this was when you were measuring the drapes at Stornoway, right? In 88?
Well, when some of the others were. And I said plaintively, we did get more seats.
Robin was happy with the color they were.
We did get more seats than we've ever elected in our lives. We did get a higher popular vote than we've ever elected in our lives. And a certain leading Canadian trade unionist pointed his finger at me and said, why did you waste $2 million in Quebec, you idiot? If you'd spent that money in Ontario, we could have been at Stornoway. And I said, because I knew I was not going to be returning to this role, if I had four, I would have spent four, you jerk. Because the only way for a party to move from being regional third-party player is to have a base in Quebec. And that is as true today as it was 25 years ago. Yeah. So from Jack's point of view, if this is his last election or if this is his second last election, it's close to the end of his career, what does he want as a legacy? Another two seats in BC or a breakthrough in Quebec?